Chapter 1, cameras. Since there's a lot of cameras out there, I'm just going to narrow it down to 3 cameras. You can use a standard definition camcorder as a Sony Handycam, or you can go all the way to an HD camcorder as an HVX200. Or if you want like something in the middle of that price, but you want an HD quality, but you can't afford an HD camera like the HVX, you can go any DSLR camera, which is around $400 to $600, depending on your model, or it could be more if you want to get a better DSLR camera. But I'm going to show you a few clips right now that's going to show a standard definition camera compared to an HD DSLR. As you can see, a standard definition camcorder is a bit blurry, the colors are not good, and it's easy to shake the camera around. As you can see with the high definition clip, you can see the colors are more defined, more clear, and the audio is way better. Clips you just seen there were single clips. Single clips is just one trick. You can use your fisheye lens or your long lens. For fisheye lens, you gotta make sure you remember the rule of thirds. You start from one side of the frame and from the other. Same with long lens, but long lens is a bit different. You can either do like a panning motion at the ending or pan in. Just remember not to get too hard to your shot, so you might miss the trick. Chapter 3 Beyond Lines. Lines is a group of tricks done in one run. It could be 2 tricks or it could be 6 tricks. Doesn't matter, whatever scary does is a line as long as it passed 2 tricks. Just remember, when you're filming lines, you gotta be close. Sometimes it's gonna be hard to avoid head cuts or board cuts, but make sure you're always close and make sure the skater's in frame. It might take a while to get used to it because when you first start filming lines, it'll be a bit shaky, but practice makes perfect, so you gotta go out there and try it until it gets right. Here's a few more lines to show you how they are. Some can be objects or some can be just mainly flat ground. If you're not an object, you might have to plan it out in your head to see how it is before you film it. If not, you might get confused and mess up on it. For flat ground, it's basically simple, just follow the skater. But if you're doing object stuff, you gotta make sure you angle the camera up a certain way so you catch the action and you don't head cut or board cut. It seems like a lot to learn right now, but the more you do it, the more you get the hang of it, so just go out and keep practicing and you'll get it over time. Chapter 4, Double Angles. Double angles are good to use because it shows a different perspective of a trick. It doesn't matter if it's a single, line, or long lens. You can use the beginning of the clip or the ending of the clip or even the middle of the clip. As long as you place it right, it'll look good. Here's a few examples to show how double angles will help make the clip look better. Chapter 5, Filming at Night. Filming at night is a bit different because you have to make sure you're close to the skater at all times, no matter what you're doing, single, long lens, or lines. Even though you have a light, there still is a distance between the skater and the camera that you have to make sure you're by. If you're not, you might drift out in the darkness because there's no light that far. Or if you're lucky, you might have ambient light around you. If you don't know what ambient light is, it's a light around the area that you're already in, that's already there, it's not on your camera. So that's just the basics of filming skateboarding. If you want to get really good, just go out there and keep filming. You're not going to get good overnight, so you got to keep practicing every day. After a while, it'll be easier and easier. You just got to keep going for it and have fun.